everyone, it's Jessica from the Coors Wellness Center, and I have your WOD for today. Your WOD is going to be a one dumbbell or one kettlebell strength routine. We have total body, strength, cardio, HIIT, and core. So a little bit of everything. It's going to go by really quick, and it's going to be a lot of fun. Get your heart rate up, so perfect for after work today, or even tomorrow morning if you want to squeeze it in. We're going to start with what's called a complex for some strength. A complex is a series of exercises all in a row, and your hands should never break or leave the kettlebell or the dumbbell. So I'm going to show you with both the kettlebell and with the dumbbell so you can visualize what it looks like. So our complex today is going to be a series of four movements. Each exercise or movements, we're going to do 8 reps. As soon as we're done with those 8 reps, we move on to the next one right away. No break, no stopping, hand does not leave our weight. So the first one I'll show you is with the kettlebell. We have a single leg deadlift. So single leg deadlift, remember we're hinging at the waist. So hinge at the waist, down and up. If balance is an issue for you, you can also do this staggered single leg deadlift. 8 single leg deadlifts, and then we have a clean to press. Clean to press. You hinge at your hips. So this is why complex goes together, right? The movements flow. So we roll down, hinge at the hips, bring the weight up, and press. 8 of those. I'll show that with the dumbbell as well. So you hinge at the waist, you bring your hips up, bring the weight up, little dip, press high. 8 of those, and once you've done 8 of those, we have an upright row. If you have a dumbbell, upright row. For more advanced, you can do what's called a slingshot sweep. So I'll show you with both the weights. So slingshot, you have your arm up and down. Sorry, high pull, not slingshot. I'll show you with the kettlebell, you're doing more of a swing with it. Swing, high pull. 8 of those, and then from there, you're gonna keep it racked, which means just resting on your shoulder, and you have a single side squat. So 8 movements, all in a row, on the right, on the left, that's one set, 3 times through. So each side, 3 times, 8 reps of each of those 4 exercises. It's gonna flow together, it's gonna be a lot of fun, trust me. Second one, we have some cardio HIIT. This one, we have one round only, so don't worry. 20 reps of each exercise. You can take breaks if you need to in between exercises or breaking up the movements, but try and keep it quick. If you really want this to be a quick advanced workout, you should be rolling pretty quickly. HIIT is high intensity interval training. So first one, we have a burpee with push-up. Burpee. Push-up. 20 of those. From there, we have 20 swings. I'll show you both weights. Remember, a swing is a hinge, not a squat. So legs are apart. Hinge. See how my back is flat? You could rest a nice little water glass on it, and I'm not going like this. That's a squat. Bend. If you only have one dumbbell, you can hold it in your hands, like a goblet position. Same thing. Your hinge. You're hinging, your butt goes back. 20 swings, and then 20 mountain climbers. That's 40 total, 20 on each side. Making it quick. Going 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 40, 20 on each side. After that, 20 jump squats. 20, 19, make it count. Next one, plank pull throughs. You can do this with either your kettlebell or your dumbbell. Plank position, just pulling the weight through, using your core, moving quickly, gets the heart rate up. That's 40 total. 20 on each side. Remember, we're only doing one round of these. So take a break, hold it in plank, drop down to your knees if you need to. That works as well. Remember, you're crossing over, twisting your tummy, bringing it back through. Standing it up, we have a reverse lunge to kick. Reverse lunge, kick. 20 and switch. If you want to make it harder, you can hold on to your weight. And two more left. We have a shuffle. Holding your weight in your hand, we're going to shuffle back and forth. That's 40 total again, 20 to each side. Last one, classic Russian twist. 40 total, 20 on each side. Rest after that, 2 to 3 minutes, whatever time you need. Stay down on the ground. That's a nice transition. We're going to do some core on the mat. For our core, we're going to do 3 rounds of this, 10 each move. First one we have is kneeling. We have a kneeling windmill. So one leg is up, one arm is here. We're going to lean down and extend back. So lean down, extend up. You can also do this no weight if that's a lot on your shoulders. Still getting a good stretch of your oblique, which is your side hip here. 10 of those on each side, then we're going kneeling, wood chops, down, over the shoulder, down and over the shoulder. 10 on each side. Coming down, belly up. You could have your weight, again, not necessarily, but if you want to make it a little tougher, we have an overhead leg extension. Arms up, extend your legs. We're really using our lower belly here as we extend our legs nice and close to the mat. If that's too tough, you can just go up and in. You also don't need to hold the weight overhead if that's too much on your shoulders. Same thing for our last exercise. No weight is necessary. Legs are up. Working our upper core now, upper abdominals, as we reach towards our toe. So that's 10. Each move, each side, 3 times through. This is a fun one, so let me know when you do it. That's your total body kettlebell, dumbbell workout. Just a reminder, this is created for BCWC members and Molson Coors employees. Thank you. See you next time.